Now, in the next topic which we are going to discuss is the parallel lines and transversal. See here, parallel lines means these two lines are said to be parallel if the distance between these two lines is same everywhere. See here, the distance between these two lines is same everywhere. Suppose if the distance is of 5 cm, means throughout the entire line it should be 5 cm only, then those lines are said to be parallel lines here. Now first topic is parallel lines and transversal. Transversal means the line which cuts these two line, passes these two line, that line is called a transversal line. Now we are going to take a parallel line and a transversal line, and what are those lines means for us, everything we are going to learn here. Now see here, the line L intersects M and N. Now here simply I have taken two lines here, the line M and line N. If these two are the two lines and one more line passing through this line, let us take this line as a line L. If these two are the lines and this is a transversal line, passes through these two lines and it intersects the line M at the point P and intersects the line at point Q. If this is so, these are the angles formed here. Now first thing we have learned is linear pair of angle. If this is a line means, then we know that 1 plus 2 is equal to 180 degree. If L is a line and M is a ray stands on that line means, then we can say 2 plus 3 is equal to 180. Similarly, if PQ is a ray stands on M means, then 4 plus 3 is equal to 180 degree. If L is a line and this M, this side it stands on the, let us take this is P. So P here, let us take the complete line is M. Here let us take this as A, B. Now PA is a ray stands on this line means, then 1 plus 4 is equal to 180 degree. Likewise, we can say for this line N also. These things we have learned. Now see, these are the two lines here. L is a transversal line means, now this line, this angle formed which is above the line, that is angle 1, angle 2. Similarly for this one, below the line, that is angle 8 and angle 7. These are outside the line here. For these two line M and N, these angle, these four angles are outside the line, that is angle 1, angle 2, angle 8 and angle 7. These four angles are outside, so this we will call it as exterior angle. And similarly, in between these two lines I have angle 4, angle 3, angle 5 and angle 6. Inside it is there between these two lines, therefore we can call this as interior angles. Now see here, these four angles are exterior and inside we have interior angles here. Now next, see that this is a line and this is the another line. Now a transversal passes through here. Now for the same situation, let us take a daily life situation. Let us take a window of a house. Let us assume this is the window of the house. Now the same thing we can take it here. If these two lines, the rod present here, let us consider these two are the lines that are parallel lines because the distance between these two will be equal only, and this is a transversal line. If this is so, then at this place the angle formed will be 90 degree. At this place angle formed will be 90 degree. When this is equal in the parallel lines means, then these two angles will be these two angles are equal and they will be called as the corresponding angles. The same thing we can say here also, angle 1 is equal to angle 5. The similar situation will be here. How much angle you are having at the place 1, the same will be having here when these two lines are said to be parallel. Given condition, if these two are parallel lines, then we can say that these two angles will be equal. That is, angle 1 and angle 5 are corresponding angles. Similarly, angle 2 and angle 6 are corresponding angles. Angle 4 and angle 8 are corresponding angles. Angle 3 and angle 7 are corresponding angles. Angle 1 will be equal to angle 5. Next, angle 4 will be equal to angle 8. Next, angle 2 is equal to angle 6. Next, angle 3 is equal to angle 7. Now, next one. Let us take this inside here. If, let us consider L is a line. These two are parallel. Let us take this situation itself. This is a line here. These two are parallel. Now, what about these two angles? When I add these two angles, that will be equal to 180 degree. Therefore, these two angles lies in the interior. So, interior angle lying on the same side of the transversal. This is lying on the one side of the transversal. That is interior angles here. So when I add those two angles, I will get the answer as 180 degree. Interior angle on the same side of the transversal, that is equal to 180 degree. Same way, here we have the interior angle as 3 and 6. These two are on the same side. Now next side, 4 and 5. So if I add angle 4 and angle 5, I will get 180 degree. Similarly, if I add angle 3 and angle 6, I will get 180 degree. This is the interior angle on the same side of transversal. That is angle 5 and angle 4. Similarly, the next pair is angle 3 and angle 6. These are interior angles. Interior angle on the same side of the transversal is supplementary, the sum, their sum will be supplementary. So 5 plus 4 is equal to 180. 3 plus 6 is equal to 180. Now see here, alternate interior angles. Alternate, this is on the same side. Alternate means opposite side we have to take. Interior angles, these four are the interior angles. For this, which is opposite? 4 and 6 are opposites. Similarly, 5 and 3 are opposite. So, interior angle on the same side of the transversal is angle 4 is equal to angle 6. Similarly, angle 5 is equal to angle 3. These are interior angles on the same, the alternate interior angles. Now, similarly, alternate exterior angle is also there. These are exterior angle. 1, 2 and 8, 7 are exterior angle. For this, opposite angle is angle 1 is equal to angle 7. Similarly, angle 2 is equal to angle 8. These are alternate exterior angles. Here, interior angles. See here, if these two lines are parallel, if these two lines are parallel, then 1, 2, 8, 7 will be the exterior angle. 4, 3, 5, 6 will be the interior angle. 1, 5, 2, 6, 4, 8, 3, 7. These are our corresponding angles. Next, inside these two lines, opposite angle. 4 and 6 are opposite. 5 and 3 are opposite. So these are alternate interior angles. Next, alternate exterior angle. 1 and 7 are exterior opposite angle. Now 2 and 8 are opposite exterior angles. So 1 is equal to 7, 2 is equal to 8. angle on the same side of transversal is, and the transversal line, one side I have 3 and 6, other side I have 4 and 6. Now based on this, we have the axioms and theorems. Let us see the axioms and theorems one by one. Now let us see that 6.3 axiom. If a transversal intersects two parallel lines, if the transversal, this is a transversal line, intersects the two parallel line, then corresponding angles are equal. That is what we have seen. 1 is equal to 5, 2 is equal to 6, 4 is equal to 8, 3 is equal to 7. Same thing, ulta also we can say. If 4 is equal to 8 and transversal is passing through the two line means, then these two lines should be parallel. This cannot be in a slant position. If these two lines are equal, transversal line is there means, then I can say that these two are parallel. If these two lines are parallel, then this should be equal. Both ways we can say the same statement. Angles are equal means lines should be parallel. Lines are parallel means angle should be equal. Now axiom 6.4. If a transversal intersects two lines such that corresponding angles are equal, then that lines should be parallel only. See here, already a transversal line is there. It is passing through the two lines and they have said that this corresponding angles are equal. If the corresponding angles equal, a transversal line is passing through means automatically it is understood that these two lines should be a parallel line only. Both ways we can say the same statement. Next is theorem 6.2. If a transversal intersects two parallel lines, then each pair of alternate interior angle is equal. Transversal is there. It passes through the parallel line means alternate interior angle. These two angles will be equal. Similarly, the next two angles will be equal. The alternate interior angles are equal. Similarly, if alternate interior angles are equal means, then the lines should be parallel. That is what the next statement is. If a transversal intersects two lines such that a pair of alternate interior angles is equal, then the two lines are parallel. If it is parallel, alternate interior angles are equal. If alternate interior angles are equal, then it should be parallel only. Both ways we can say the statement. Next, theorem 6.4. If a transversal intersects two lines, then each pair of interior angles on the same side of transversal is supplementary. See here, if these are the two lines here, transversal passes through these two lines means, then interior angle on these two sides, interior angle on the same sides of this transversal line, when I add these two, that will be supplementary. Supplementary means A plus B, that is equal to 180. That is angle A plus angle B is equal to 180. If these two are equal to 180 degree, then these lines should be parallel lines only. Next statement is, if a transversal intersects the two lines such that pair of interior angles on the same side of the transversal is supplementary, then the two lines are parallel. If it is supplementary, then it will be parallel. If it is parallel, then it will be supplementary. The next theorem is 6.6. The lines which are parallel to the same line are parallel to each other. Understand the statement clearly. Line which are parallel to same line. See here, I have a line A. Let us take the next line B. And the third line, let us take it is C. Now, I have taken a condition that line A is parallel to line B. and I know that line B is equal to line C. Line B is equal as well as parallel. Now similarly, line A is also equal and parallel. This is what we have given. Now see, A is parallel to B. Now B is parallel to C. Now say, take the example of a window itself. Now see here. Now I know that this line and this line is parallel. I know these two lines are also parallel, and also I know this line and this line are parallel. Let us give the name L1, L2, L3 and L4. L1 is parallel to L2. L3 is parallel to L4. And I know L2 is parallel to L3. If it is so, I can say that L1, L2 is there. From L1 link going to L2. From L2 link going to L3. From L3 the link gone to L4. So directly I can say about my L1 and L4. Therefore I can say that L1 is parallel to L4. Same thing only here. A is parallel to B. B is parallel to C. So from A link gone to B. From B link gone to C. So directly we can come from A to C. Therefore A is parallel to C. That is what given here. A line which are parallel to the same line. This is a line. This is the another line. These two are parallel to the line B. If it is so, then these two are parallel to each other. Then the lines are parallel to each other. This is theorem 6.46. Now based on this theorem, we are going to solve the few problems in the next exercise.